You know, sometimes some weeks I start in things and it goes in lots of different directions. When we're speaking of uncommon genius, we're speaking of something that we all have within us, which is a power and a talent and a creativity. We know here that we're one with the one power. At least I hope you know that by now, those of you who tune in regularly. This may be very new information to people who are here for the first time or who are just learning about religious science or learning about what it is to be a truth student. In the center I was associated with in Fort Lauderdale many years ago, every single Sunday they sang a song, "How Great Thou Art." But when it's sung in a religious science center, the meaning is somewhat different. When you're talking about in awesome wonder, how great thou art, what we're really talking about is the presence, the power that is within each of us. The lyrics express the awesomeness of creation that can be observed by anyone and everyone, and in all things great and small. As you can think of the vast solar system, it's there. If you can think of the miracle of life in everything that you can conceive of, it's there. From the smallest particle within to farthest recesses of space that your mind can conceive of, it's there. This sense of awe, as you can if you just really delve deeply into the idea of perfection, everywhere present. There's not a spot where it isn't. Or we used to say, there's not a spot where God is not. So the more we contemplate that, and we can look out at, you know, sceneries of nature, and you know, you just can be overcome with a sense of, here I am in the middle of this, and I'm one with this, and it's in me, and it's operating through me. We'll say, Spirit is, God is. It's the Alpha, it's the Omega, it's everything. It's the all in all. In other lessons, I've talked about the challenge many people have in their lives, regular people, being what I call other referred. Therapists know what that phrase means, and some of you know what it means to be other referred. For a great many, all they think about is others and what others think about you, to a point where you don't know yourself. You're all caught up in like, does this person approve of me? Does my teacher, does my boyfriend, does my girlfriend? It's all about what they think of you. And in this teaching, we move away from that a bit, and we're a little bit more preoccupied with our own thoughts and thinking our own thoughts and being less and less referred to the other people in our life for approval. There's a lot of ordinary people who haven't thought much about who they are or who they have come here to be, which is part of what we do in our Q process. Whenever we discuss it, we ask, this is who I have come here to be.